You hear it? It's a sound. The sound of tea. Do you know what that means? It means it's time for some code.
An emergency, can't you see? Do you know why we stopped the car? Do you know why we stopped the car? Guess, guess what?
What? Do you know why we stopped the car? I forgot to close the door. Occupied slots. Go ahead, turn this, bring up the manual. Do the commands. I am assuming, right? Y'all can see us? Just stop being such a dumb butt. Alright. Let's see here. The good origin is bottom left. Let me ask you, can it's injured, and number of victims are in the following area. Alright, so I think I'm going to sub one from MX0 on each iteration. And then, do some code. And then jump if not equal. Jump if greater than zero to the loop. Huh. 15 by 15 slots. So I think you write them all into memory. Say 100. Right, angles into memory, so I get NX100. Let's just write it here. F4 to R0. R1 is R0 plus 1. R2, R3. Actually, they saw it 0. Yeah, one first. And then number of cells. Non-zero bytes here. Wait, that's my tea. Did they leave the tea on the counter? Tastes like tea. Anyway. Let's not say MX. I'm gonna say MXTG is determined. We're going to store the original value of bottom left corner. The original value of left one into the R5 register. See here, let's see the comparison operators.
Oh.
Okay. No. Ah. I'm realizing right now, we have these comparison commands. Output to 1 to P1, otherwise P0. I can do this much smarter. I can do this much more. Let's save this here, because we might go back to this. But I just had a brainwave right here. First try. Make a new one. We can, instead of doing that, we can loop over. Yeah. So let's view the, let's see what we did here for the initialization. I want to copy this. I can definitely, like, make this more in the future. Why is it for people watching the stream? What? I could definitely make this one shot in the future, but, you know, right now. And then, we could do this. Right? So instead of, like, saving this in memory, we then loop over each byte of output. So I'm going to move into R for 100, and then let's see here. For each iteration, we're going to divide what's an R for. No, it should be a multiple of 15. So let's say 15, 150. So then to say, move into, take the modulus of R4 and 15 and move that into R5. R5 is going to be our X for this situation. And then we're going to see if, we're going to test if R5 is greater than R5 is greater than, it's greater than or equal to, it's greater than or equal to. We're going to move. First, we're going to move. We're going to take the minimum. Yeah, let's move a 1 into R6. We're going to. Actually, no, we don't need to move one to R6 right now. We're going to test. Move into R6. That what's currently in R5 is greater than what's being pointed to at R0. So what's being pointed by 0 is greater than R5. Right, and so then you want to test if what's being pointed to by R1 is greater than, that's an R5. We also want to use... How many registers do we have? I mean, we have a lot of space. We could just, like... You know. Start using memory for it. For it not to, because it's, like, not really a memory sort of thing. But... I mean, optimizing by commands anyway. Like, who cares? Not me. I don't care. Don't even care, Baka. Registers, registers, registers. We only have up to R7. Huh. Alright, Alright, so you want to keep zeros. You want to max. Yes, you want to max. And then it being one is a bad thing. Great. Max of R6 and R7. Then we're going to check if what's... We're going to take R4 and divide it by 15. Yes, yes, yes. We actually want to start it to. R4 divided by 15. And we want to put that into R5. This should be MXR2. We want to test if greater than put into R7 that MXR1 is greater than R5. And if it's not, and we're going to want to maximize that. Maxi R7 score 7. We're going to... This can be... I just thought of a way we could do this monitor, but we're not going to do this monitor yet. We're going to just make the solution, and then we can optimize later. Take... now test F less than RS, put to R7, MXR3. Into R5, we're gonna maxi R6, R7, and then we want to add 150 to R4. We want to subby. We want to sub what's currently in R6 from. We want to sub 1 minus what's currently in R6. And we want to put that into the memory address. You want to put that into R6, actually. And then, because we have it flipped, and then we could do the minimum. Take the mem of R6 and the memory address put into by R4 and put into R4. You won't be doing bytes. All of that should be bytes comparisons and whatnot. Are they null bytes or are they unsigned bytes? Bytes, okay. B. 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 B, 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 B. Oh no, not the bees. Let's see. Oh, actually, wait, no. Now, anything we need to do with R4 is integers. 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 Integer. Yeah. And then we're going to want to add 1 to to R4. What's 15 times 15? Actually, you want to add... We already added... So you want to sub... by 149. So 225. So jump if less than... If R4 is less than 225... We want to go back to iterate, bow, 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 iterate, bow, 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 iterate. So let's see if that works. I could set it to pink and settings? Yeah. What is this? Huzzah! Ooh. 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 See, I like pink. It might be slightly giving me a migraine. But let's stick with it. Let's stick with it. Let me view. Yeah, this 150 is way too much. Just call it 50. Actually, let's make it like by a line too. Put it into here. You're viewing bytes. I want to see your bytes. Alright, so save this. Occupy slots. Second try. Yeah. Compile it. Back successfully. Actually, wait. I want to stop you. I want to actually. Okay. Run and pause. So this is all of our. So I'll see the rest of you. So it doesn't go to 64, that's good. That's good, I'm assuming it doesn't go to 64. These are integer, these are bytes. Yeah, so this is the first thing. And let's just resume and see what happens. Okay, the first quote-unquote rectangle appeared to not actually do anything in memory. Because it's between 6 and 7 and 9, 4. This would be a situation where, like, bytes per row 15 would actually be good. Oddly enough, but you can't set a... do you see anyone's? Because I don't. So something has gone wrong. Certainly, the registers have stuff gone stuff. Having 4 bytes would be great here, since it forces each rectangle into one line. But the way I'm doing this, right, is that I'm going to be using the bytes for, do this, like, yes, we could do, because the way I'm doing this, I'm actually, like, I'm setting the memory spots to, you know, oh, bytes per row 4. Yeah. You ain't wrong. Yeah, see, 6 and 7, 6 and 9. And that's not what's happening now. So, So buttons on blue and you make a big bang. So what's it's a unit of energy. Let's see here. So I'm noticing now that we're not actually setting but R6 being reset, none of this matters. R4 being -31 is not necessarily what we want. Because we're viewing it as a byte instead of an int. R4 is 225. That should be, that's what we want. R6 is 0. R5, what are you saying, R5? R5 being 14 is good, because it's actually, wait. Is 15 slots. Yeah, okay, that's good. Yeah, that's what we expect. R5 being 14 is what we expect. R6 being 0 is... R6 being 0 is what we would expect from there. I don't want to run this code manually, but I think we don't have to. Okay. Compile, run. So we've initialized this to R0 is pointing at 4. R0 should not be pointing at 4. Oh yes, yeah. R0 contains 4. So what are we keeping in? So R4 is looking at 0. Next one should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so this is a 6x7 and 6x9 table. So that's going to be an, what's 7 times 15 is, 7 times 15, 7 times 15, 7 times 15, 105? Okay. Oh, he's stepping, yeah. 9, 10. You are at 1 R5? That's implying that the first ones you saw were... I think R4, 264. No, R5. Yeah, because you already passed the thing. Yeah. That's right. And 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Wait, 7. Since we want B. Okay, so you want. Okay, so we're at line 11. R5 gets set to 5. So this shouldn't work. So we should expect to see a run into R6. That's correct. I'll view these as unsigned bytes. There you go. That makes more sense. That's easy to follow. That's not. Why is it 174 now? Oh, because it's currently going upwards. Yeah. You said the thing. It had 111. 111 is at 6. So this should not be sent to 0. So it should not be set to 0. Yeah, it should be sent to 0. The 13 check should also pass. Yeah. Now we're at line 14. Maxing these 2, which is 0. Line 15. We're dividing our 4 by 15 to get to learn that we're at the 7th. I already skipped some. Oh. Now we're checking to see that we are not greater than RS7, which is the case. Now we're checking to see if we're not greater than, not less than R9. Oh, you're maxing it, yeah. Which you can see if not less than R9, which is the case. Now we're subtracting 1 from R, so this is 1. So at memory index 175, we should be putting in a thing. Which we don't. It's because I'm looking at bytes, not unsigned bytes. Is this like a weird... No. Min B. MX R4. And R6. R4. R4 is putting it like 170-something-something. And... 176. Try putting it in there. Oh, because you're taking the minimum. We want the maximum again. We want the maximum again. Right here, yeah. Max B. Stop. Compile. Three, 4, 5, 6, 7. You see that? That's the smell of victory, my friend. And so now, we set 0, come to the hidden 0. And then we move Move this here. And then R4 will already be at 2. I need to move 115 to R4. What are you doing at now, actually? 64? Add 1 to MX0. Add MXR4 to MX0. He actually skipped the subbing malaki and deal with the menbi if he did sub here. That's another optimization in the future. And then after we move MXR4 into MX0, now add them together, we're going to sub, add 1 to R4. It should be add B, actually. And then, count and jump if less than R4 is less than 235. 235 to 64, call 400 to count. Let me exit. Save this. Save, compile, run. Stop this. Compile it, run. Did not work immediately. This is so sad and so unfair. Okay, you can stop. That seems to be right here. Wait, what? Really? It's working first try. Look at that. Is it 8 into our memory? 8 into our memory, okay. Where do we want to start? Just go like 10,000? Yeah, I like 10,000. Where is it? There you go. See, that's good, right? We're not going to have any memory conflicts, huh? Because it's going to take a long time to run again, but there you go. This is such an efficient flow game I made. I don't think 150 plus 64 is 400, but you know. Who's counting? Not me. Do you mean memory access errors out of bounds? Oh. Yeah. No, that makes sense. Stop. Compile. Go. There you go. Pie. Apple pie. Goes well with tea. Tea. Let's mess around with the colors. Custom. Is this just dark? Yes. Nah. Pink is best. Pink is best. I got used to the migraine. Guess who did it? That's right. Leaderboard? Occupy slots. Oh, my commands. Most common. There we are. You say this, right? Yeah. Most common. I mean, make a folder for that. Going to save this into most common. Memory has a 0, contains an integer A. After that, you have a group of A integers. This is coffee. I drank my coffee and some of my decaf tea. I want to go to sleep tonight. Wait, most common integer. If multiple integers are most common, 3 slots should contain a sum. Okay. Now, I might... I'm not necessarily going to make more assumptions since we're strictly required in this problem statement to try to get like a more hacksery code. But I'm not doing that. These are ints. Make it at 16. 32. 16. Okay. McVilly, you know, as long as you're underneath here, we're chilling. I'm not seeing. Alrighty, alrighty. So, I'm going to offset them by 1,000. So, we're going to move, you know, we're going to move 0 into, odd 0 is going to be, input head. I'm going to have R1, you know, just be some casual temp. Let's see here. We're gonna move what's pointed at by R0 into R1. And we're going to add what's pointed at by R0. We're going to add 1,000 to that. Then put into R1. And then, you know, we could just like not what's pointed at. We're going to take what's pointed at by R1 and we're just going to add one to it. We're just going to add like a little bit one to it. And then, we're just going to add one to R1. And then if it's not, just have this little loop here, and if it's not equal to, if what's R0. Wait, one. We're adding one to both of them. And then if it's not equal to 0, we just jump the loop, right? And so the output of all of this is that now we're gonna have a frequency table of all the things located at location 1,000. So now we're gonna have a second loop. We're gonna move R1, R0 to 1,000. You know, we just like go there, right? Let me see here. R2 is going to be previous max. Int. Gonna be max a scene. So like, you know, we gotta have this little like loop two here, right? You know, and as long loop two, as long as you know, I mean, let's just like keep going until we're going to add one to it or zero each time. I just have to keep going until we've seen, like, you know, 2,000. I don't know how big these numbers are. So, like, let's just have 1,000 of them. Let's see if they can have a maximum of 1,000. You know, I'm sure that's fine. I'm just going to shove and go to loop 2, and then loop 2, all you're going to do is we're going to not biggest. I'm going to jump to not biggest. These all should contain a sum. Multiple. if the number we're looking at right now is less than the maxine, max going to be max be the amount of max. Which is going to be R3. Going to fast forward to not biggest. It's not the biggest. Then we're going to add them together right now. Now we're going to put it in. If they're equal to each other, we can put it in. And so the other solution, so now we're going to reset R2. We're going to add R2 to what we're looking at right now. Obviously, we're going to subtract 1,000 from that. And I'm going to move max R3, what the amount we're looking at. Actually, in R2, we could do MXR0 directly. Zero, MX0, MX0, and otherwise we exit. And now we're going to save this. We're going to compile this. We're going to stop whatever's running. At line 15, we have an incorrectness. MX. Why did I start putting underscores? And compile this, thank you, run it. Memory access misaligned. Yes, because this should be by 4. 1,000 is supposed to be by 4, right? I think so. These are going to be bytes. Yeah, stop, compile. So this should be 1. It should be bytes. These are all. R0 is going to be an int. R3 is bytes. 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 Line 10. I think I have a memory access when I should be the and move int. This should be move int. You got some wine on to investigate, huh? If only anything could ever feel this good again. Hey, compile it. What? Unpaused. So now add 1,000. Should be bytes. Okay. It's just a 1-1, actually. That's not right. That's not right. Are you not doing your job? No, it's because we only did the first thing. Okay. Now at 1,000. You are at line 11. This should not be not equal bytes. It should be I. It should be 4, because they are stored as ints. Yeah, these are stored as ints. They're ints. They're ints, Randy. They're ints. In that case. I'm going to divide what's in R0 by 4 before we throw into R1. And let's just hope this works this time. No, it did not. All right. Let's go here. Stop. Compile. One. All right. So as a reminder, we have 5. Look at these ints. These are 5, 1, 1, 3, 1, 4. We go down to byte land. We go down to 1,000. You see palm here. It's all 1. Guess it should be MXR0. But then we don't need to write it, actually. Yeah, we don't need to write it. Suck myself up. Out. Stop. Compile. Run. Hey, sometimes working. 38 out of 50 is. The passing grade? A star, right? A star, that's a pathfinding algorithm. You're not gonna do that until Simple Maze. Loop, add. Yeah, we want to add B, MXL1, to 1. Stop, compile. Spam test case doesn't work. 8. What's your issue? Yeah. It's a lot of mail. Okay, let's see here. There's 1, 2, 3, 33s. Guessing these are all the cases where this multiple not biggest. These as bytes. 2. Well, I think there's 2 1s. Which can assure you is not the case. So this is still on. Oh, we want to skip memory as you. Oh, okay. It's not a zero in the array. It's a something else. Okay. Yep, just be R5. move 4 into R0, and then multiply, put some 0 by 4, into R. Put that into R5. Oh yeah, sounds good. Save, stop, compile, run. Compile, run. Better. Let's do 5 here. Why not? Instead of just 1,000, you know, that's weak sauce. It is. It's weak sauce. It's weak sauce. I'm not that weak of a person. 20,000. Okay, I don't think this is the solution. Somehow that made it even worse, which honestly, you know, might be impressive in itself. I'm just putting it out there. Oh, because it's seeing zeros now. And I don't like zeros, Sam, I am. Would you like them if they were clams? No. Would you like them if they were spam? No. I do not like zeros, Sam, I am. Would you like them if they were warm? No. Would you like them if they were a worm? No. Would you like them if they were shouts? No. Would you like them if they would pout? Would you like them if they like ants? No, I do not like three-letter hands. I do not like them, Sam I am. Would you like them if they were tough? No. Would you like them in the rough? No. Would you like them if they ate bees? No. Would you like them if they sneeze? No. I think I'm gonna call it here for now. It's been an hour. And I'm stuck. So, I'll catch you on the flip side. Thanks for watching. Fare thee well.